Welcome students, welcome to the subject of apparel production management. Till now we've covered almost 8 units wherein we've learnt about line balancing, WIP, throughput time, capacity like potential capacity, etc. We also learnt a little bit about line balancing wherein we did a minor case study. Also, we had a couple of numericals wherein we tried to do simple mathematical formulas on how we set up a garment factory. Now, we are going to look at a case study which is going to encompass all the topics that we've studied in apparel production management. We will be taking an example of a real-time factory, a garment factory, and we will try to understand how capacity planning is done, how a factory is being set up in terms of different lines based on the current operators and the labor available. We will also try to understand about how WIP is managed, how line balancing is done. We will also throw light upon skill matrix and how to understand the line's performance by hourly production reports. So let us start with the case study of the factory XYZ Textiles. Now, let me give you an overview of how the factory functions. The factory is a tops and bottoms factory. It is a woven factory. Tops and bottoms. So, two lines of the factory, there are in total 4 lines, wherein two lines of the factory work with shirts and two lines of the factory work with trousers. The trousers are semi-casual and this is not a formal setup. So, the factory has, like I said, 4 lines. V1, V2, V3 and V4. There are 4 lines like I said, and V1 deals with shirt. Now, like I mentioned, the shirt is a casual shirt and V1 has in total of 35 operators planned. And the target efficiency of V1 is at 70%. V2 is a line which works with trousers. So, we can write it as bottoms. The target amount of operators in V2 is 30. And the efficiency that is to be achieved is also at 70. Let us move to line V3. It is again a shirts line with operator capacity of 30 and a target of efficiency fixed at 70%. And the final is bottoms with operators of 30 and 70% efficiency. Now, as you can see, the factory is in total set up at 70% efficiency. That is the target efficiency that is to be achieved. Alright, and it has 4 lines, like I mentioned, 2 lines dealing with V1 and V3 dealing with shirts, and V2 and V4 dealing with trousers, that is bottoms. Now, we should also take into account the SAM values that will come in. So, on an average, the shirt SAM values would range from 20 minutes to 25 minutes depending upon the complexity of the garment, and the bottoms that this particular shirt is handling has SAM values ranging from 8 minutes to 14 minutes. Now, why is there a high gap here? It is because the bottoms could be trousers or it could be shorts. So, depending upon the complexity of the garment, the SAM values change. So, this is something you've learned today. The SAM values change based upon the garment product type. We should also note that the factory works at 8-hour shift, that is 8 into 60, 480 minutes. This is the factory working time. So, the major factors here being your number of operators, your target efficiency that you have kept, the SAM values that are assigned to a product, and the time that is being given. So, like as we have done all our calculations before, only these four details matter to calculate a factory's efficiency. So, the only thing that is going to vary out of which is not mentioned here is the production, right? But we've got four data based on which we can directly calculate the capacity of the factory, right? Now, what we are going to do is we are going to take a live example wherein we will be taking one style in each line and assign the exact SAM value to the line and try and calculate the capacity of each line. Now that we've assigned product types to lines, let us try and calculate what should be the production based on SAM value, which should be achieved at 70%. Alright, so in line V1, the product is a shirt, correct? So, now the style number, let us try entering the style numbers, and based on the style numbers, we will try and put what is the SAM value that is given. Okay, these are the basic details that needs to be there before understanding capacity, line balancing, skill matrix, etc. So, please understand the main four factors that will affect a line. One is SAM value, production, target efficiency, and the time that is available, right? So, the product in line V1 is a shirt. So, the style number for the shirt is MOSLB. Alright, and the SAM value for the shirt is at 22.3 minutes. So, what is the what do you understand from this? The operators present in line V1 is 35, and the target of line V1 is at 70%. We have taken up a style called MOSLB, which is a shirt style, and the SAM for that is placed at 22.3. Let us take the line V2 now, wherein the style number is 6379524. Since it is a trousers line, the SAM value of the garment is at 12.35. Line V3, the style number is 6321254. We've discussed this as a shirts line, so the SAM value of this particular product is at 20.48. The last line is V4, which is again a trousers line. The style number here is 6381. 0101, and the SAM value is placed at 10.16 minutes. So this is the set, current setup that we have. So now that we know what styles are allotted to which lines, we should try and find out what is the target production that these guys can give, each line can give at 70%. This is our target, so we need to see whether it is going to match our plan. Let us try and calculate the production with the given circumstance for each line. For V1 example, let us take the example of line V1. Now, what is the formula for efficiency? Let us try and recap. That is the only formula that we generally use everywhere. So, efficiency is denoted in percentage. Correct? So, efficiency percentage is equal to SAM into production divided by number of operators into given time. This is the formula that we've studied and we've been using in most of the numericals. Now, what are the details that we have? Efficiency. Yes, we have the target efficiency at 70%. Do we have SAM? Yes, we have style-based SAM. Do we have production? Production is yet to be calculated. We have the operator details as well as the time details. Operator is mentioned here. Time is basically the total working time. So, which is 8 hours. Like we calculated in the previous slide, 8 into 60 is 480 minutes. Let us try and find out the production factors. So, when we put everything in place, 70% or is equal to SAM. What is the SAM? 22.3 into production, which is what we need to find out, target production, divided by operators, here would come as 35 into the time. Time here would be 480 minutes. Alright. Now, this whole formula will get moved here. So, production is equal to that is 70% can be written as 70 divided by 100. So, it is 0.70 into 35 into 480 divided by 22.3. We've made production in the question column, so we moved everything to the other side. Let us try and calculate the answer. If we do that, 0.70 into 35 into 480 divided by 22.3 is equal to 527 pieces. So, what does this say? The answer we've got is 527. So, to achieve a line target of 70%, we need to get 527 pieces with 35 operators. Because SAM is going to be constant, the time is also constant. The only two varying factor here is going to be your production and your number of operators available for that particular day. Correct? So, to achieve 70% efficiency with 35 operators, we need to produce 527 pieces in a day. So, as we found out, we need to make 527 pieces. So let us try and calculate for line V2. So the factors here would be, efficiency is constant, the SAM value is at 12.35, and the number of operators changed to 30, right? So the answer here for line V2 will come as 0.70 into 30, which is the number of operators for line V2, into 480 divided by 12.35. Let us try calculating the answer. 0.7 into 30 into 480, which is the time available, divided by 12.35. We are getting the answer as 816 pieces. So we need to make 816 pieces of this particular style with 30 operators, so as to achieve a target efficiency of 70%. Now let us try calculating for line V3. So in V3, the efficiency target is at 70%. The SAM is at 20.48. The operators remain the same and the time remain the same. So the here only changing factor is the SAM value, which is at 20.48 minutes. If we calculate for line V3, it is 0.7 into 30 into 480 divided by 20.48, which comes to 492 pieces. So to produce at 70% with 30 operators for this particular style at a SAM value of 20.48, we need to produce 492 pieces. Let us do the final calculation for V4. Now, the efficiency factor remains the same. SAM changes because it's a trousers line, 10.16. So, 10.16 into production, which we need to find out, divided by 30 operators, which is the same, and into 480, which is a time allocated, 10.16. So when we calculate the formula, it comes to 0.7 into 30 into 480 divided by 10.16, which is 992 pieces. So for V4, for this particular product, which is a bottoms product, a 30 operators with a target efficiency of 70% and SAM value of 10.16, we need to achieve 992 pieces. So this is the ideal scenario. All factories fix up a percentage of efficiency as target, and based on that they plan out on the lines. Alright, now that we know what needs to be achieved per day, we will try and see whether it fits the potential capacity and the current capacity of the factory. Cut. Now that we've calculated what is the target production at 70% for each style, let us see whether it correlates with the order quantity. So, the order quantity in total for line B1 is 2,694 pieces. The order quantity for line B2 is 7,081 pieces. The order quantity for line B3 is 2,825 pieces. And the order quantity for line V4 is 3,666 pieces. Now, in a very simple factory where there are only 4 lines running and with limited number of labor, we can see the amount of variation in the order quantity. We can also see the amount of variation in the SAM values. So, always we need to take in the factor of the complexity of the garment, and we also need to take in the factor of the total order quantity so that we can see whether we will be able to achieve a particular capacity, and also how feasible is it to achieve 70% with the existing order quantity. Let us try and understand now how many man days are required to achieve and complete the order quantities for each line. What is man days? Man days refers to the number of days a particular line has worked in one style. I repeat, man days refer to the number of days that particular one particular line has worked for a particular style. It is generally discussed in the terms of man days in the planning department so that one can understand how long we need to plan before shipment for sewing. Alright, so it's very simple to calculate man days. We already have per day production, that is the target production at 70% for each style. Now, all we need to do is find out how many days will it take to complete this order quantity. So, the man days for V1 would be calculated by the formula total order quantity divided by production per day. Right. Now, what is the total order quantity for V1? It is 2,694 pieces. Divided by, what is the target production for one day? It is at 527 pieces. So, the number of days that needs to be given or allocated as per capacity of line B1 is 2,694 divided by 527. That is equal to 5.11 days. So, as per the ideal scenario that the line achieves 70% on each day and we also have full operators inside the line, that is 35 for V1, then we will only need 5 days to complete the whole order quantity. Please understand, this is the ideal scenario and necessarily will not be replicated inside the sewing line, because we do not know what is the absenteeism percentage in the factory. We do not know if on a daily basis the factory will be able to achieve 527 pieces. These two are the varying factors like we mentioned before. So, depending upon your absenteeism percentage, your actual performance of the line, that is the efficiency on a regular basis, this will change. This has a chance of increasing, not decreasing, because no factory can perform consistently at 70% because of the varying factors of absenteeism and line performance on a daily basis. Okay, so that we will work out aside. But please note, this is not the ideal scenario, but this is to get the right picture on how many minimum days is required to be allocated to the factory for producing 2,694 pieces. So, generally, planning department will have a cushion of a couple of extra days allocated to sewing so that they do not run short of time during shipment. As we can see, we'll need 5 plus days. So, minimum is 5 days. So, the extra allowance each planning department gives will vary depending upon the past record of the company. Alright. So, and also understand, this is only the sewing days. We need to add in the cutting days or the finishing days. This finishing will refer to your packing processes or your ironing processes. Alright. So, this 5.11 days only refers to the number of days that will take in sewing department to complete an order quantity. Alright. So, it is 5.11 days here. Let us try and calculate for line V2. So, for V2, the total order quantity is 7081 pieces and the production per day target is at 816 pieces. So, when we calculate 7081 divided by 816 will give us 8.6 days. This is the minimum number of days. For line, this is for line V2. For line V3, the total order quantity is 2,825 pieces. Divided by 492. Let us also find out for line V4. So 3,666 divided by 992 will give us 3.6 days. So, as you can see, there are so many various answers we are getting that is so different irrespective of the order quantity. These two are similar order quantities when we come to trousers. One has 2,600 pieces, another has 2,800 pieces. More or less, these are similar order quantities. But as you can see, the target production varies due to which the number of days it needs to be completed also varies. Also have a look at the Russel's line. Due to the high variation in the SAM, the number of man days is completely different. We have 8.6 days, whereas we need to make this at 3.6 days. Alright, so SAM plays a very major formula in the whole dynamics of the sewing lines. Okay. So the target capacity for this line should be allocated at 8.67 days. Correct? That is a target to achieve the order quantity with the current scenario. Now this is the target, which is the ideal scenario. Now let us see what is the potential capacity of the line. Okay, so what is potential capacity? It is how much the line can do with whatever circumstances are provided. Correct? So now let us take into consideration the previous factors that have been haunting the line. So as per the previous records, it's been noted that the absenteeism is at 20% and the line has been performing at an efficiency of 65%. This is again the average scenario that is taken from the previous records. Now, with these two factors which will come in, we obviously know that all the 30 operators are not going to be there on a continuous basis, because there is a standard 20% absenteeism. Also, the line performance also hinders at 65%, wherein the planners have planned at 70% as target. Now, the whole point of potential capacity will come into picture and will change the dynamics of whatever we've calculated. Okay, so let us first see how many operators will go less when the line is at 20% absenteeism. So, operators will be calculated at 30, which is the current set of operators, minus 30 into 20 divided by 100. That is 30 operators into 20%. So this is what is the absenteeism percentage, which will be minused from the total number of operators. So the answer here is 30 minus 7. The answer is 30 minus 6. That is equal to 24 operators. So, our calculations should be that this is the ideal situation, but the scenario is not the same. We only have 24 operators coming on a continuous basis to the factory. So, we need to re-evaluate everything at 24. Correct? Also, we have the line performance at 65%. If that is the case, we know that the efficiency percentage is calculated at SAM into production divided by operator into time. Now this factor changes at 65%. SAM remains the same because SAM is always constant into production, which we need to find out, divided by operators. Now operator here will be 24 into 480. So now the potential production is at 0.65, that is 65% efficiency into 24 into 480 divided divided by 12.35. That is at 606 pieces. So, now that the potential is at 24 operators, 65%. Sam remains the same, whereas your target production comes to 606 pieces. If the target comes to 6, has dropped down from 816 to 606, then let us try and work out the man days. Now the man days will be for V1, V2 is equal to total order quantity divided by target production, which is at 7081 pieces divided by 606. If we calculate that, the answer comes to 7081 divided by 606 at 11.6 days. So, just by two factors, namely absenteeism and line performance, the potential target dynamics have completely changed to 11.6 man days. This is the target capacity. Now the potential capacity is at 11.6 days. Alright. So there is an increase of 3 days directly here. Now the second question comes. The planners have taken the order for 7081 pieces. What is the ship date for the 7081 pieces? We already had planned for 8.6 days, whereas the past record makes it to 11.6. Do we have time? Do we have time to give to the operators or to the line? Now time is constant. We need to work 8 hours. Production is constant if we are only going to work with 24 operators and at 65% efficiency. So how do we try and juggle? Let's say the planners have now got a tight shipment, that is planned dates for shipment is only 10, okay, which means the planning department is only able to allocate 10 days to line V2 for the production of this tile. But is it physically possible, practically possible? We can't, because it takes a minimum of 11.6 days for production, that too with 24 operators and 65% efficiency. What are the factors that can be changed to help them achieve a 10 days? Now when we look at it, the only option goes to, you need to increase the production. What should it be for 10 days? The production per day for 10 days would be 7081 divided by 10, which is 708 pieces. Right? This is something that we can't change, which has to be achieved. We need to get 708, whereas with the current scenario we are only able to achieve 606 pieces. So now comes the planning department and the sewing department's work. We can either try and increase the number of operators, or we can try increase the working time. Ideally everything is taken as 480, We should now look to see whether we need to do double shifts or we need to increase operators, because performance can't be increased out of the blue. It can be only increased gradually. So these are the only two options left. Either we increase the number of operators or we increase the total working time. Another option could be allocating these extra pieces to another line, to an adjoining line. We also know that V4 is also a bottoms line. Probably we can do that. So these are the factors that go inside capacity planning. Hope you guys have gotten a very fair idea on how to calculate, allocate operators and efficiencies and man days to lines. This is the ideal scenario. This is the common practice which is followed in all of the garment industries with basic styles. Just imagine with the complication of styles, with the varying order quantity and difficulty in sourcing of labor, all these calculations becomes extremely vital in calculating and ensuring timely delivery to the customer. Now we will be discussing in detail about the style which you are studying under line V2. The style is a bottoms, that is a casual pant with a draw cord and a folder hemmed pant. We will discuss in detail about the various operations involved in sewing the pant, through which we will also understand the SAM values which we've given and allocated for the style. As already mentioned, the SAM value of this style, line V2, SAM value is at 12.35 minutes. This is the sewing SAM, or we can say it as machine SAM. There's also something called helper SAM. Helper SAM refers to that time or SAM value that is taken to complete helper operations. Helper operations could vary from trimming of the thread, checking of the pieces, ironing of the pieces, recutting, measurement marking, notching, etc. So since those do not involve a machine for it to be performed, those timing will come under helper SAM. Please note, helper SAM is extremely important, but we should also try to reduce this as much as possible. Now the helper SAM for this style is placed at 2.59 minutes. So the total swing SAM will be 12.35 divided by 2.59, which is 4.76. Sorry, 14.76. So the total sewing SAM for this particular style will come to 12.35 plus 2.59, which is 14.94 minutes. This is the total sewing SAM of the line. Now let's say we have 5 helper operations according to the OB. Then the total number of operators in the line. Here we already are having, let's say, 25, and we have another 5. So in total 30 operators, 30 workplaces where we can do 14.94 minutes as for SAM value. Now we need to calculate now what will be the target per day. So target per day is calculated. Yes, it comes with the efficiency formula. So let us go with the efficiency. Now let's say the efficiency is at 100%. Ideally everything is calculated at 100%. Then we convert to what is the performance of the factory. So if this is at 100%, Sam here is 14.94 into production, which needs to be calculated, divided by time, which is 480 into 30. Okay, please note, this is the total Sam and this is the total number of workplaces. If we are going to only calculate with swing Sam, then instead of 14.94, we should be using 12.35, and similarly, instead of workplaces of 30, we should be taking in 25. So now if we calculate production at 100%, we need to put 100 divided by 100 into 480 into 30 divided by 14.94, and the answer comes to 480 into 30 divided by 14.94. 963 pieces. It comes to 963.8, which can be rounded off to 964 pieces. Now this is at 100% efficiency, right? Now when we calculate this at 70%, which is the efficiency performance of the line, then it will come to 964 minus 964 into 70 divided by 100. That is the total number of pieces at 100% minus the 70% off which we are getting. So the answer we will be getting here is 964 into 0.7 minus 964. So when we calculate it at an efficiency of 70%, all we need to do is 964 into 70%, that is equal to 964 into 0.70. The answer we get is 674 pieces, 0.8, which is equal to 675 pieces per day. So this will be the target fixed per day. This is how the number of pieces is being calculated in the operation bulletin. Alright. There is also the factor of pieces per head. Pieces per head is a very important factor or a terminology which is used in garments. That's a very simple calculation. Let's say if we are talking about 675 pieces at 70%, then how many operators did we mention? 30. So pieces per head would work out to 675 divided by 30, that is equal to 22.5 pieces per head. This basically gives us a standard factor on which the factory is performing. Now let us go in detail about the operation breakdown, how we break down the operations into elements so that the sewing operations can be performed in order. Switch to audio for operation bulletin.